Ban on purple. Nidalee, completely expect. Purple side banned because she's the tier 1 jungler. Overall, Jankos is also a fantastic Nidalee player. But it's interesting to see that Origen actually have room to ban out TF on purple.
And no alterations to the ban strategy just yet.
Plenty of altercations.
Yeah, there's no altercations.
Thresh and Sivir were the last ones that were banned in game one. Trundle will be the change here for H2K. I mean, Sivir is open and available. Is it first pick worthy?
Yes, it is. Champion is by far the most tier 1 AD carry, especially in a meta where lane push is so important, where bot lanes seemingly are afraid to go for kills anymore because there's like double TP available and junglers. Every time you take a step forward, somebody comes out and shoot you, so like you just want to push. That's all what Sivir wants.
Thresh as the final ban from OG, respecting Vander like they did in game one, so there is the potential for a first pick.
Yeah, there's also the challenge here. Do you pick the most broken top laner in Ekko, or do you pick the Sivir, you know? Forgiven or Odoamne, who gets his cookie? Origen have left Ekko open, which means they need to prove right now that they can play it. Otherwise, they show a big weakness in pick and ban for the remainder of the series, which very well maybe. One game.
Very true. Kindred as well would be a nice lock-in from OG. I mean, Amazing did fantastically with the pick last time around. They don't choose to bring out the Ekko here and we'll go with the Braum instead.
Same rotation?
Lissandra's up. Yes, same rotation. Lissandra is up. Poppy's up. Ekko's up.
Yeah,
Witch
so
is up.
H2K first rotation last game went Ekko Braum. They've adjusted that to give Amazing the Kindred again. So Ekko's still up and available if Odo wants to take it as this time around.
So there's like, people say, Braum is fantastic against Sivir because he can destroy the Q, you know, and the ricochet. But the problem is you now have a melee support where you give H2K, out of all people, the access to maybe a range support. If they can get a big tank on Odoamne or at least some frontline and tanky jungler, you could put a range support on Vander. And Forgiven and Vander can just AFK push you in your tower over and over and over. And suddenly that Sivir counter becomes a lot harder to play overall. So I think that's what they're going to look for. Maybe Janna. Hopefully maybe some Karma. I like me some Karma support. Only in that lane is just really obnoxious to lane against. And it's, if you go back one year, Spring Forgiven favorite playstyle, you know? Range support with some sustain, pushing the tower, whittle it down.
Some sustain. And so we do have the new next two pickups from H2K will be the Ekko. So, I mean, they get the best of both worlds. They get the Ekko and they get the Sivir and Corki for the mid lane. Leaving Lissandra up, though. So interesting that Ryu's priorities will go that way. Again, it's still a flex. You can flex that into ADC, but I don't see why OG wouldn't pick the Lissandra here.
Yeah, I mean, Ryu has answers ready. He's shown that already, so he wants to just counter pick if possible. If not, he's forced to blind pick. I don't think Origen will lock in Lissandra here. I think they want to see if they can get a counter pick on Ryu at least, because it's the most influential matchup, because mid lane right now decides what kind of the definition of your comp is. 1-3-1, 3-1-1, double TP, single TP, assassin, side lane, etc, etc.
All right, so SoaZ is going to opt into the Maokai versus Ekko matchup. This is something we've seen go horribly wrong for Maokai's multiple times, despite the fact Poppy was up and available as well.
Ekko.
Sorry, correct. That's it. Maokai into Ekko. But yeah, so leaving that mid lane for a counter. Origen, it's much the same as they ran in game one for the time being, and if they want to round it out with Alessandra. Point and click, kill something. That is what Maokai and Alessandra want to do.
I wonder what the jungle answer is going to be. Maybe, range support plus Graves would be nice here, but then you don't really have a true defined tank. Because generally you want somebody like an Alistar to hold the frontline busy so you can get set up parallel conversions. Ekko generally isn't the guy that wants to go in first. So, wonder what we're going to see here. Graves is just such a strong pick overall, though. Yeah, there it is. The Bard Hover I like. I think it's smart. Sivir Bard is so potent when it comes to pushing. Can escape. Can get caught off guard a little bit because there's no hard CC guaranteed. But if you respect your range, definitely really strong pushing lane.
Can definitely create those catches. We saw OG take it last game, and that's really what got them a lot of their early kills, was that and the flanks and OG playing around that early game Bard.
And I really think the early game is going to be so important here for Origen. Because the H2K have got so many squishies, if a Maokai can get ahead, if they can find a way to kill somebody and maintain a lead, there are some ways to get advantages here for Origen.
Yeah, so we're looking not at the 1-3-1 double TP comp, because Corki generally doesn't run that. So we're looking at a group siege comp, kind of 4-1 later on, where H2K just pull the trigger and annihilate people. Mid lane Karma comes out here into the Corki. Very, very interesting pick. It's very deceptive. Karma. She does well in extended team fights because she can get access to multiple Mantra procs overall.
Yeah.
Her Mantra E can shield the entire team, speed them up. It's insane. It can shift the entire scope of a team fight. If you want to enjoy some really good Karma play, I advise watching Faker in some team fights, despite going 0-3 in lane early.
He keeps missing like skill shots in lane. I've seen him miss minions with his Q.
But team yes, fights, Faker. He doesn't miss.
It's Faker.
So team comps all rounded out. H2K gonna have all of the damage to play with. They're gonna have Ekko and Graves as their primary front line. And for Origen, they've got some team fight, they've got some pick, they've got some wave clear. So options around. A lane swap game again, if you were to predict this one.
Yeah, definitely. Oh, if Origen get a lane swap off, they will be happy, happy, happy campers. If H2K get the standard lanes and they play out their comp correctly, we'll need to see some really good ganks from Amazing. One more thing I really want to see today, Tempered Fade into Parallel Convergence combination. You can just straight up win your team fight.
Yeah, of course. All of that AoE CC. We'll find out whether or not H2K are up to the task. And if Vander as well as Odo can actually hit those targets. There's your team comps, guys. Origen were winning, what, 75% of the team vote with hashtag OG win. If you think H2K are going to bounce this one back, hey, they're 1-0 up in the series. You have to think they're going to earn some votes.
Yeah, the forecast here shows that H2K, there's a northwesterly wind that will be giving them some votes in this one, Trevor.
All right, we'll find out who will be voting for them. Jump onto Twitter, hit us up at LOL Esports. The crowd here is hyped as we load up into Origen versus H2K. And we will be blue-red in the next two games if needed. With H2K opting into blue side. All right, standard fan, and I can't see the makings of a lane swap yet.
With your bird's eye view.
Oh.
Crushing stuff, you probably can hear that. Debris everywhere.
Yeah, Crawford has crushed a water bottle. But Jankos and Amazing just squaring off here. It comes the ward from Soa, so there's still time to go for a swap if they want to. Because really, if I was Maokai, I would not be a happy little tree going into Ekko. That's just not a matchup I like.
Yeah.
Definitely not. And Sven and Mithy, they're going to have a tough time as well.
Yeah, your lane will be called Crimson Red. Yeah.
Although, are they swapping now? 1:10. It looks to be the case. Mithy and Sven moving
both teams. Yeah, both teams. So
all the bluff.
H2K know that Origen is likely to going to initiate that swap. Mm. Let's see. There will no. There might be a camp stop. I think we'll see Forgiven go lane. Vander go stop the camp reliably. Let's see if Mithy and Zven go for an invade. It's because they expect a swap situation. Mithy wants to move in. Origen, H2K rather, now get the confirmation as well. They're playing with more info. Oh, they can punish this face check here.
Well, Mithy's going to go down.
No. They haven't seen. They know he's in there right now, yeah. But they're going to waste time. So Zven, actually.
Did
Forgiven,
they?
No. Forgiven knows that if he goes for the punish and they chase Mithy, what's going to happen is that Sven's going to push in first. And the entire scope of this lane depends on who gets the push advantage. Sivir bar double range, get it early. Right now, they have control of the mini wave. They don't have to push it right now, but they push it whenever they so please. And then they can start poking down. So, good thinking here by H2K. Not greeting for the kill. Just consolidating the push first, and then looking for poke, and just denying CS on the tower. Nothing's going to happen in this lane. We can look at the other ones.
And that's what I'm going to do. Let's go to mid lane. Ryu and PoweroFEvil is a cool one because we're finally seeing that Karma. Bit of trading in the bottom lane as well, but they're two beefy tanks. Cool to see Karma come back into mid lane now. We'll see how much you can do in the mid lane because she does a lot of damage. If she lands a Mantra Q, it does so much. And of course, with the shield as well, it's like a ghetto Civet ultimate. So you can speed people up for a shorter amount of time.
Yeah. The 99 cent store Sivir ultimate overall, but the true power for me, Karma, lies in a Mantra W. It's so deceptive because it deals damage and it gives you much health back. Mm-hmm. And it's such a powerful trading tool. And at the end, they're snared, which gives you an easy Q if you can land hits on stationary targets.
Because it's missing health as well, you drop her low and it's just like, oh, she got 40% of health back. That's unlucky. And then you just lose.
And it just adds to the CC chain that Origen will be able to throw down the later this game goes. Maokai, Karma, Braum. H2K going to be a lot more reliant on landing those skill shots, predicting with the Tempered Fate and Parallel Convergence.
Mithy has a fun game on his hands, though. He can literally block projectiles, multiple projectiles from every single member. I mean, look at Ekko, Q, Grace, all his spells, Q and R. Odoamne trading on SoaZ here. SoaZ not getting any minion assistance. He's so far behind his own lines here that his range creeps are not helping him.
Not just yet. Bit of poke in the mid lane, but so far it's just a lot of trading going on. Bit of an advantage in the bottom lane from Odoamne, but When are we really going to see some more action happen? Are we actually going to see a prolonged laning phase in this one?
I mean, we will see some ganks from Amazing being attempted here. We have push here in the top lane. We have control in the bottom lane. And then push in the middle lane. Three lanes being pushed in. It is so hard to gank. And if you get counter jungled once or counter ganked rather once, the game is set in a very, very tough position for you if you're Origen. So no room for error whatsoever.
No, and somewhat similar on the side of HTK because of that limited teleport. H2K played with so much respect for that Tempered Fate in game one. Yeah. I expect more of the same against the double TP here from Origen. So that's going to allow, we're going to maybe slow down this game until a lot of power spikes have been hit.
The thing is, HTK, their dual lane and the top lane here, will always keep a maximum distance between each other. And they'll never allow Mithy to get a deep ward in. Like, TP is fantastic if it comes from behind, but when are they ever going to get a ward behind the enemy 2v2 here?
Hey.
We see a fight for Scuttlecrab. Amazing wins.
Gets a stack.
1-0.
Definitely worth. Up in the top lane, Forgiven and Vander continue to shove in. Look at the CS discrepancy.
Yeah.
Great cosmic binding.
That's Mithy's fault, though. You need to put up your shield there.
Yeah.
Really good at Vander. Perfect play, you know?
Yeah.
But there is a counter, you know? You can't throw that projectile.
Not this time around. And 38 CS to 21. Sven under a lot of pressure under this tower.
Nah, this is brutal. It's like, you see all the CS, and this one, for example, will be hard, but then Mithy executed. But once these ranged ones are poked down, it becomes so hard for Sven to get CS.
And Van's getting jumped on from Mithy. Jankos is here for the counter gank, though. Mithy is going to have to flash away. Sven already in full retreat, is out of mana, so did have the back of the jungler there.
Yeah, that's a play pattern. The way you break poke sustain matchups is by all-inning. For Braum, that means jump through creep, get your passive off, and then blow them up. Immediate reaction, though. Almost too much respect from H2K. They want to be the first one to land the teleport if SoaZ is teleporting somewhere. Yeah. So while Odoamne is figuring out, okay, are they acting on the teleport, he can then still cancel his. But we see really the weight, the pressure that H2K is putting here with this Forgiven push.
Yeah, working in their favor. 44 CS to 30. SoaZ will use his teleport to get back to lane, keep some pressure down on Odo. Odo's not backed yet, so there's a cowl advantage in favor of SoaZ. Amazing does not have access to respite yet.
So, to see Jankos in the bottom side just clearing out those Krugs, and Odoamne backing off the tower as well and picking up that cannon. So, still significant advantages in those side lanes.
Yeah, we could have seen a swing from Jankos to the bottom lane, because obviously when Amazing reveals top, there's a window of opportunity in the bottom lane. But Opsu just clears jungle over and over and wants to bridge that farm gap. He wasted some time top, so he wants to make sure he stays even CS, maybe hits level 6 quicker, and then Grace can come in for destructive ganks.
Yeah, let's get that collateral down.
Ooh.
PoweroFEvil, 50-odd CS. Mithy's gonna keep pushing.
Well, Vander wants this freeze here, if he can just buy some time.
That's a lot of damage.
Nice. He's fine.
His custom minions.
Still has a health relic.
Yeah.
I mean, once Braum uses Q, it takes a while for the second one to come out.
That's true. If only he had Flash and Ultimate. And anything, actually.
Or Ignite.
Or Ignite. Triggered!
Well, talking about that, Ryu's the one running Exhaust on the side of HTK. This game, Mithy will be holding it for Origen. Vander's also got the additional Ignite, so some kill pressure if he finds some good Cosmic Bindings. On the first back starting to come in. So Sheen for Ryu, Catalyst picked up for PoweroFEvil. He's also got access to that Mantra, going to carry on spamming out, or rather, point into the Mantra. Carry on spamming out those waves. Matching the wave push actually with Ryu's Corki. Pretty well.
Looking for a gank in the mid lane. Tether's gonna connect onto Ryu. Got the Q as well. Amazing coming in from the side. The Wolf's Frenzy. But with Vander coming in with the Cosmic Binding and Jankos coming into the fray as well, this could turn around for H2K. But with the zoning and Mithy also coming into the mix, we're just gonna see a disengage.
Yeah, that was straight out of Dynamic Q. Some missed skill shots.
Yeah.
Everybody gets juked, of course. It's never missed. But yeah, good attempt here, good reaction. Both teams ready for these little skirmishes. Nobody goes down.
Nope. But we're going to see an invade from Amazing. Sorry to step on your toes there, Trevor.
No, it's good.
I like this fight for play-by-play dominance.
It is, yeah. It's like...
It's the equivalent of Pulse raising his leg. And
yeah.
This is my turf now, Trevor.
Well... I don't even know where to go from there. I'm just not going to touch it.
I'd prefer that.
Yeah.
Gentlemen, Jankos is rinsing and repeating in the top lane. Mithy, no flash from the previous engage where he actually went all in. Teleport is available for PoweroFEvil as well if anything were to break out. But
cross look at play, though.
Odo's backed. Yeah.
There's a TP, and Mithy, he's raised up the shield, but he's not going to have that for the next couple of skill shots coming out. Jankos, he's going to clear out the Krugs while he's setting up this gank, because I don't mind me.
Oh, boy.
Here comes the teleport. It's going to be 4v3, as the TP does complete out from PoweroFEvil. Parallel Convergence, it could be pulling the trigger here.
Not just yet. The Soul Flare comes down, empowered by PoweroFEvil. Mantra's on cooldown. He needs to get some tags. Cosmic Binding, locks Mithy against the wall, and spins the target.
And Sven's going to go down. Ryu is dropping low himself. He'll back away, and the Q lands from PoweroFEvil. He'll follow after, and with the auto attack, he'll finish him off. But it's still a negative trade. It's a 2-for-2.
2-for-2 with first blood going to Zven, who saves both summoners. Yes, H2K will take his tower. Look at the bottom lane. Amazing. Was setting up a gank there, but his gank key kind of teleported to the top lane, so he decided to base and go top. Origen should have not gotten away with two kills here. They outplay H2K in this exchange. 5v3 with teleport burned and a setup advantage on the side of H2K should have been a clear kill.
And this might be another one. Glacial Fish is down. Vander will not be able to escape. He gets dropped. Defensive flash for Forgiven. Origen are going to take a tower and a kill lead and the gold lead.
I mean, we've been questioning H2K when it comes to team fights with skirmishes. Again, Amazing's in the bottom lane right now, trying to gank a teleporter. That's going to go top anyways. Map mistake. But here, Zven gets first blood by just straight up shredding Jankos. And PoweroFEvil after landing Mantra Q, another Q, and then jumping in for W proc. He gets another kill, and Mithy manages to survive. Even gets level 6 on that entire exchange. And that then influences the next part of this play, where Vander is oh so close, but just can't quite get to the portal.
Can't quite do it. It was so close because the ultimate almost lands onto two people, then he'd be able to click the portal and it would be fantastic. But alas, it did not work out for the Bard.
It'd be the equivalent of Luigi winning in Mario Kart, you know, yeah. When there's a little stare, takes the portal, he stares down when he leaves, but nope.
Not today, unfortunately. Well, he's going in this time.
Sven's gonna be able to dash away. Tower's very, very low. Origen have got the current tower lead, they've got themselves 1,500 gold advantage, but that will be going away very shortly once Forgiven and Vander are able to push the wave in. Take a look at the summoner spells. Only Jankos has flash for H2K. And over on the other side, PoE is the only one who's used his flash. So some summoners can be used in the next few minutes if more skirmishes break out. But another early game where H2K fall behind Origen.
Yeah, more importantly, SoaZ is just chilling in the bot lane right now. He's a happy little tree. PoweroFEvil gets closed on though. Parallel Convergence into stun, but Amazing's here to zone. Yeah. That's not really going to do much. Yeah, SoaZ can push whenever. Odoamne is trying to force a play to equal out the teleport and then maybe get an advantage later on, but Orange is not buying. They're playing very well defensively. The fact that they survived at 5v3 is just utterly impressive. A little bit of a mistake on H2K's side, but props to Origen.
And Smite comes out, and it's going to go over to Amazing. He's on the Herald, but he doesn't want to go toe-to-toe with that thing. There's actually very few champions in the game who can solo it. Karzix, funnily enough, is one of them, if you pop a point into your ultimate of Evolution. Did you know fact right there?
At least can.
At least can, yeah.
It's cheating, though.
Yeah, Yorick can alone. As well.
Yorick,
yeah. Yeah.
I'll remember that when I play Yorick jungle.
Yeah, fantastic champion. Amazing and PoweroFEvil pushing down the mid lane. And maybe able to pick this one up. There is Ryu defending.
All right, TP. Teleport is being used by SoaZ. Big pressure on the top, like flash away! SoaZ will root Vander in place. The support is coming into the lane. Forgiven and Vander, they're going on a magical journey, and Amazing's hopping over the wall. He dances of arrows forwards. There's a lot of damage. Lamb's respite will need to come out. Vander's locked just on the edge, and the support comes in from Origen. They get themselves a kill.
Titanium, what just happened in that team fight? SoaZ actually didn't even know it was a good idea to go for the magical journey. It's like, well, you're just gonna get Cosmic Binding, but apparently it was a good play.
Yeah, a leap of faith here, but the play took so long to execute, mostly with the magical journey, that H2K take a cross map bottom lane tower. They take a lot of damage in the mid lane tower. So overall, I don't even know if this is a net gain for Origen. They used the teleport on that play too, and the flash from their top laner. Which is, again, Vander tries to do the right thing, stopping. This would have been an insta cancel on SoaZ. He flashes out. But then they path towards the wall, and this is really important. It shows you that H2K is used to playing with Bard, because most of the time people path into lane in big curves. But when you play with a Bard, you want to path towards wall, so you can always get the journey out.
Very smart on the small mechanical stuff, and ultimately Amazing as Lamb's Respite allowed him to stay alive and pick up that kill. Again, good contribution, 2-0-0. So 50% in terms of kill participation this time, and he's picked up both of them. So this time, he's going to go for the recurve bow, so it looks like he's going to go for a similar build with the Runan's Hurricane. And also going for the Hunter's Potion, so he's always going to be healthy. when he goes for these ganks and taking this dragon as well. So this worked out really well for Origen. Yes, they did lose that tower, but now they have that dragon advantage.
Yes, they do. We'll need to equal out the towers to at least regain the gold lead that they picked up. It's going to be a little more challenging. Infinity Edge already completed for Forgiven. Ryu's on the Trinity Force. Odo's making his way towards big items. And SoaZ, first teleport was okay. Like, it netted a kill, got them some dragons, but I want to see how he continues to find opportunities and openings, because it's going to be so integral to locking down these carries on the side of H2K.
I would argue it was a bit of a waste if it's against any other bot lane combination, but the speed combined with the mobility, can you call it, when you're moving through walls from the magical journey?
I think that's the definition.
Yeah, I think so too.
It's moving on lanes, not through walls.
Wow.
But yeah, that made the play cost so much time that it was cross-map potential, and an even trade with teleport being used generally isn't good usage.
Well, there's a flash in the bottom lane from Odoamne just because the tether was going to land from PoweroFEvil, so it didn't even want to be under attack by Amazing. So we'll be backing away, especially as Lance's Bite is up from that spot.
Teleport comes in.
Well, let's find out if SoaZ will go down. Tempered Fate denies the tower damage, and SoaZ backs away. PoweroFEvil's in trouble. He's the target. Braum Shield comes up from Mithy. He's buying time for Origen. They're staying alive, and PoweroFEvil's running for his life. Time Winder and one more Z-Drive Resonance will take him down. They've traded one for one. Odo's looking for more.
What a messy fight. Mithy's so low, but Odoamne, he just simply can't finish him off. That's one kill to the tree. The shutdown comes out. 3-1 over to Origen.
Yeah, H2K, usually such a smart team, go for a play that backfires completely. The bar ultimate disables the tower, but not the teleport. Vander could have waited for the teleport to land, but they try and burst down SoaZ, but this is why people like Maokai, it's very tanky. Then PoweroFEvil comes in. The fact that he buys so much time here, look how where he is in the fight. He flashes the Ekko ulti, then forces Odoamne to kind of chase him. But meanwhile, everybody's dying in this tower dive here. Good punish again from Origen overall.
And then, in the end, Odoamne, what are you going to do? You have to just walk away and have the devil beaten out of him by Maokai.
And if you're Origen, you must be happy, because you're playing with a TP down, and guess where H2K is making the play? On that same guy without the teleport. It's like, thank you very much. I guess I don't even have to teleport in anymore. I'm already here in the fight. And we're seeing some of these mid-game power of a Maokai and a Karma in these fights. Super tanky, plus shields.
And just before the fight was about to break out, as going to mention how H2K were pushing the waves and pushing the lanes down. And then they committed. They actually did sort of the inverse of Origen. Origen had the advantage early in the previous game, and they didn't go for those tower dives. This time H2K do, they make mistakes, and allows Origen back into the game.
And usually this is not what H2K do. They just keep max range and whittle down a tower, then maybe rotate to a different lane, and guarantee that you're outnumbered. So
maybe a sign of some of the practice that H2K has been putting in. Going outside of, I don't want to say comfort zone, but going outside of their traditional style.
Diving a Maokai when PoweroFEvil and Karma has TP up, I don't think that's good practice though.
Yeah. Guys, we're going to practice tower diving in bad situations and see how you respond with your mentality.
It's the good, mental practice. Yep. Focus on improve.
Exactly.
Gravity chamber goes up to like 3. I speed a little bit early so we can really practice from behind.
So what was the gravity chamber settings in game one?
Origen broke it, I think, at one point.
Well, we've got another game where Origen is ahead. It's not as clean in terms of how far they're ahead in this game because they've lost some of those towers. Of course, some kills going over to H2K, but you can still see this this trend where OG are getting ahead, not only because of their own plays, but H2K just kind of serving it to them on the silver platter sometimes.
Yeah, Ryu here. Package available. They want to keep matching Maokai with the Ekko to deal with him, PoweroFEvil with Ryu. Later on, though, PoweroFEvil will have teleport advantage over Ryu, who's running exhaust. That's when the 1v1 really works into Origen's favor, if they can, again, pull the trigger somewhere.
Now, a lot of damage on the side of Origen. Hurricane completed again for Amazing, despite not having the same lead in the previous game. So this is becoming his standard build throughout the series. Culling just a force for giving away, but it's not really going to open up access to the tower on the side of Origen.
I mean, Amazing right now is 900 gold ahead of his counterpart, Jankos, in a matchup that we came out saying in the analysis too, is like the crucial difference in this matchup is Jankos being much better than Amazing. So far, he has shown up completely. Really good punishes on this kindred pick.
I think we're going to see a tower trade here. Ryu's just pushing up the top lane, but we'll be able to counter the push, and Sven does the same. Okay, we do have Mithy coming in from the side, so that's also the pressure, knowing that there could be SoaZ in the wings as well, which he was.
I like what Origen is doing here, putting Amazing as an additional member on the side lanes. He did it last game too. Remember what he was doing out? See a trade in the mid lane though, this might be a fight.
SoaZ is in trouble. Vengeful Maelstrom comes out to tag with the Winter's Bite into Jankos and defensive peel from Origen. They're not willing to commit for the follow-up, realizing they had a numbers disadvantage. Instead, wave clear, save SoaZ's life. And Amazing is going to be jumped on. Nope, Odo holds the phase dive secondary proc.
Rio will clear out this pink ward as well. SoaZ is just trying to deny vision through Fog of War. He's just sitting here just in case someone steps forwards and he can jump on them. He has flash available as well, which would be fantastic. Now Amazing's coming in and we might have this counter push.
Yeah, there was a tempered fade, so it's on half cooldown right now. Was used likely when Amazing showed in the top lane for that duel. H2K tried to force. Origen, you don't have to flash, just stepped out of it.
Alright, Mithy, Unbreakable Will is up, blocking at least some of those projectiles. End of the line, I think, ended in front of the shield as Origen are just going to extend that lead. 2,000 gold, 20 minutes in. The big story is these top laners. They were allowed to farm, allowed to get freedom. SoaZ is plus 20, just finished up his visage. Odo, he's got 3 kills. He's getting closer to that Sunfire. It'll be integral to see which frontline tank can have a bigger impact in these team fights with all the damage standing behind each of them.
I mean, Ekko is all about trying to get that instant burst off onto a carry. Like, you can chunk them real hard, but it's harder to get that off rather than Maokai just jumping into a team fight with zone TP and just point-clicking on a carry, and then you just dogpile them, right? So in this game, Odoamne will find it fairly difficult. Like, there's a Karma with the zone, there's a Mithy as well, and we might have a team fight opening up here. The young steal from Jankos.
Cheeky.
Yep.
Walks in, thank you very much. Dragon number one picked up by H2K. Stolen by H2K.
Yes. Yeah.
Let's see how well Origen can split up here. Keep that three-man squad in the mid lane, put SoaZ and PV on the side lane, make use of that double teleport. Because when we grouped up, we're looking at a lot of poke here. Corki, Sivir, even the Graves. In terms of team fights, something we were alluding to, Ekko wants to flank for sure. Because we have a beefy front line that has access to mobility boosts from the Karma too. So you're really going to get from behind with a zoning parallel convergence or just engage on the carries, bypass that front line as best as you can.
Culling has already been used in this middle lane, so has a Mithy.
Yeah.
Trying to do the hold off as Sven is already recalling.
H2K is locking up Origen. They're basically telling them, you guys can't multi-roam because you need more people defending this mid lane tower because our siege is so strong. And because Origen haven't initiated the 1-3-1, they're kind of stuck right now. And they will eventually lose this mid lane tower unless they commit a lot of members to defending it over and over.
Origen, I'm looking at wards. There's not a lot of vision behind H2K for any potential teleport plays. And tower pressure is continuing to go. Mithy's moving forward. On the hunt, used defensively as Forgiven's run out of mana, and the Tempered Fate won't do a thing. SoaZ locks down a dead target. The Cosmic Binding locks up OG. They get themselves one.
That was a TP used from SoaZ, though, to come in at the end. I'm not sure if he was strictly necessary. Odoamne is still pushing down in the bottom lane. Now he's recalling.
That was a super good reaction, though, from Origen. They identified the threat. It's like, guys, we can't play our strategy. We need to go for the hard engage. Tempered Fade was not used optimally. SoaZ going in.
Oh, here we go. SoaZ jumping under the tower. Forgiven's low. Jankos is also out of mana. Odoamne now comes into the fight, but he's kind of alone. No one really can do anything from the rest of the team. Power, he's split from the pack. He'll jump away with flash. SoaZ is back into the fight. He throws out the Q. Oh, Forgiven goes down. Jankos will be limping away. Odoamne back into the fight. And Amazing's chasing him down. Vanna's just not there in time. Odoamne also drops. And Sven with the double. 3-0 to OG.
Phenomenal team fight here from Origen, really understanding what position they're in terms of the scope of the game. They found themselves locked down in the middle and they go for hard engage. That's not enough. SoaZ, he sees an opening and everybody commits. They disengage when the parallel conversion comes out. Amazing ducks a drive by, save my teammate's ultimate, and then goes for the chase. Fantastic overall, and look at how quick this Baron falls.
It's already secured. Origen are very low. Ryu needs to Valk away defensively. Origen should be able to escape here safe and sound. 4 kills at the end of the day, 3 kills rather, as well as Baron at 22 minutes.
I mean, look at it, the decision making here. The ward, bottom right of your screen, you see the TP. I want to see what Tempered Fate is used, because ideally it should be used on 3 people here. The Vander has to use Portal defensively, and then he's stuck. He goes too early. He doesn't cancel SoaZ. He would have been dead anyways. But H2K, if you want to push that far off, you need to be ready to use that Tempered Fate and your teleport offensively. Because look where Odoamne, he is just so late to the party. I love that Origen read this play. They flash out, nobody gets stunned. PoweroFEvil goes for the chase, and look, amazing here. They finishes off the tower. He's going to identify that SoaZ is dropping here. He's going to dash in, drop the drive-by on SoaZ, make sure he lives, and now go for the chase on Jankos. So the spatial awareness in these fights from the entire Origen squad is just on point. Good synergy, good decision making, and they get a Baron to boot.
H2K are just so scattered in these fights, but maybe they'll find a nice pick onto Mithy as he's just trying to push into the jungle. Package also from Ryu might pick up a second kill onto Amazing. He's being chased down, and Ekko in these situations just so good.
This is such a good punish from H2K overall, though. Origen get greedy. They try to speed up the Baron process, but they're still down some ultimates and some key flashes, and they blind invade the jungle. This is the third time in recent memory we've seen Amazing do this. One in this game, one time versus Unicorns of Love, where he got caught out by Fox by the Frozen Tomb. So this is something Origen do need to work on. Take your time once you have that Baron buff.
And Mithy as well. It's that duo going in there, because Mithy last time we saw going into the top jungle when they were blue side, and a very, very similar play happened. SoaZ now just getting so tanky, 106. Has the Spirit Visitors, the Sunfire, looking towards either an Icemourne Gauntlet or even a Frozen Heart at this point.
Yeah, and if you step back and you look at 6,000 gold in the lead for Origen, losing two members with the Baron buff, that's most likely going to stall out this play, and the fact that down to only 1 minute of timer remaining. But power is continuing to grow. Sage Devour for Amazing, as you've already mentioned. Ryu's going to get closer to that Infinity Edge. So those power spikes are growing, but I think it's so crucial that Origen have got this very strong lead, and they'll have Teleport available for SoaZ very, very shortly.
Well, strong push down the mid lane from Origen. They should be able to pick up this tower fairly easily. Sven tries to get a little bit of poke down. That was a little dodgy there as Vander almost landed the Cosmic Binding. But now another push into the mid lane. Clear out most of the minion waves, so they'll have to back off for at least one wave.
Yeah, Brute forcing their way in, and I like SoaZ really far forward, threatening a potential dive with that Twisted Advance, and H2K instantly back away.
Yeah, and they'll stay around the mid lane again, just look for this next push, and they should be able to chunk it down. It's just where H2K can get an engage off.
Let's find out. Parallel Convergence will lock up Mithy, but nothing more. Cosmic Binding, I think, pinned him against the minion wave as well. Minions are still standing, going a little low.
It's too late.
Tempered Fate's been used, and H2K can't chase further.
It has to be close to the base here. H2K want to really find the punish. Origen is doing a good job kind of backing off at the right moment, so they're not overcommitting. And I want to jump on something you said there. SoaZ on these tanks, I think the meta shift has kind of helped Origen, because SoaZ was struggling on these carry roles. In these longer duels, think of like the Fiora Poppy lanes, where he's supposed to carry really hard. He just wasn't that player anymore. Now in a simpler meta, where it's all about team fights and you play point and click kind of tanks, I think it's helping in hiding one of the weaknesses from Origen. Have to obviously bring up that SoaZ wasn't always failing due to his own faults.
Yeah.
His team wasn't setting him up for success. But with a tank now, it's a lot easier. Put him in the side lane, soak up waves, TP and do your job. And it allows Zven to shine even more.
Yeah, and in this particular game, those standard lanes, despite being Australia, and the fact that H2K put some early teleports down from Odo, it gave SoaZ the windows of opportunity. All right, Origen will lose their outer mid turret, take a small knock to that gold lead that they've accrued, but H2K can't really do a whole lot with it, and double teleports for OG. So 1-3-1 is most likely what they will be looking to set up.
Yeah, they could do it again. They could do 4-1-2 if they really want to keep power close for speed boost to catch somebody out. But they should make use of that teleport advantage they have. Baron has fallen off, which means there is no way in hell you will get any tower on Siege Lockdown because there's so much wave clear. So you just need to push Deep Vision, isolate an objective, whether it's like a Scuttler, a Herald, which is no longer there now, but like a Dragon, later on the Baron again, keep the Vision control, and then punish H2K on the next Baron. That is Origen's goal right now.
Of course, so we just got a quick glance there of Amazing. Built himself up 5 stacks there on that Kindred passive. Doing very well. Dragon number 2 picked up Origen. That's a lot earlier than Dragons in game 1. Not really a high priority, but yeah, it'll help. A little damage over time.
Still not even super fast either. And Odoamne back into the bottom lane. He's charging up the parallel convergence, but this is just to get a bit of shield just so he can take a lot of these creeps. PoweroFEvil lands the snare. Q. Bit of damage there. And Odoamne is being pushed out, but the rest of Origen looking to back up PoweroFEvil.
Oh!
He gets chunked as he jumps into Ryu. Had to take a step back.
And this is what H2K do very well. When behind, so many teams would yield that brush, the brush above there, and just say like, you know what, push, we'll figure it out once you get to our tower. But H2K has been aggressively defending Vision in their own jungle. That's how they cut out Mithy and Amazing. That's how they chunked out somebody just right now. And that's how they defend their jungle with these two pink wards. And it just doesn't allow Origen to push in deep enough to set up any rotations to take full control and then choke H2K out. So they really understand how to play from behind. So far the series though, they haven't really understood how to not get behind.
That's definitely the case. Definitely not helping the cause either with some of those early tower dives. But regardless, now the tempo is squarely slowed down. Origen still trying to find some openings for Vision. Denied in the bottom quadrant, so they say, screw it, let's go top. Baron's up in like 45, let's try to get some Vision around that area. At least have the option to fall back to it if an opportunity presents itself. Because we're approaching 30 minutes, and again, at 30 minutes, Origen of the team with the lead.
Yeah, this Baron melts though. That's the thing. It's also so much easier to bait from purple side, especially when you have your miniature Sivir ulti with Panther E. So you can defend the choke points. Braum can also just block one off, just throw his body in there, and then just ultimate, put the shield up. And in those like 5-6 seconds that Braum can buy time, Baron is just gone. So H2K, very dangerous position. And because SoaZ, he's not pushing on the bottom lane right now, yet, he's gonna fix top lane. H2K just getting pushed in on all lanes. Need to see if Origen can pull the trigger right now though. Can they just immediately start that Baron?
Well, that's what they're gonna do. Yes, they will, Crepo.
Ooh, they do it with a cheeky two-man though. Blue trigger comes out.
Well, they can do it. I mean, SoaZ is tanking up and amazing has percent damage, so it's gonna go down fairly fast. But I think H2K know what's up. Mithy's zoning away, but they had one of the entrances where they weren't able to defend it. And now with the Tempered Fate coming in, they're gonna turn around onto Ryu.
Baron and SoaZ have been stopped. Jankos is going to position himself on the front foot. Baron's been stopped at the cost of a teleport.
All right, we can see H2K rotate mid here with the Sivir ulti being used already, so they no longer have it available. So that's a generic answer. You're in the river for an objective. We go mid instead, push you back. Origen almost sneaky though. Good awareness from H2K, knowing that two people is missing and two people is all Origen need for that Baron.
H2K stop the Baron. They're unable to push further. They've lost their teleport on Odo. It was traded with PoweroFEvil's TP, so SoaZ is now going to be the man that has to play the side lane.
He's pinging bot lane.
Yeah, bunch of pings.
That's smart, because they have teleport advantage, so he wants to push out the side lanes right now. See if they can set it up again, but the setup is costly. Takes some time to get into the jungle. They no longer have the tank available either to face check for them.
If baiting is that much easier for Origen on purple side or red side.
I prefer it.
And I remember Sean's was saying he didn't like red side because of the viewing angle on the HUD last week. But regardless, the point that I want to mention is the next two games, Origen are on the red side. So the game has played out in a fairly similar big picture style with Origen approaching 30 minutes, playing around badly. Starting it off.
They use their teleport for it.
Early TP, but Odo's not there. Odo's coming through the jungle. He's only caught mid lane. Mithy, Glacial Fissure is not available, and the Tempered Fate's been used. Origen, they peel
they can
away.
Finish it now, though. SoaZ is peeling. He's shutting off the entrance.
They're still on the Baron, though, and SoaZ doing a great job of zoning. Amazing's dropping low, but he does have Lamptress Bite still. Jankos, both of his shields have been popped. Odoamne comes in. OG pulled the trigger. Lamptress Bite will help both teams momentarily, but will not help Jankos because he goes down. 1-0 to OG, and they may be healthy enough to turn around. Odoamne is coming in from the side.
Let's find out what he can do. Chrono Break's already been used. Flash is available. 35 seconds before Jankos comes back alive. And I think very crucially, Mithy has access to that Glacial Fissure. It is a powerful tool in these tight chokeways. Ryu is dancing around on the front line. A flash forward from Sven. He doesn't find the kill, but he's zoned Ryu away.
So low though.
Baron has been started. Amazing.
He gets the
summoner
heal.
That's
so critical.
Yeah, I guess the Maw proc, which stays when how long he stays in combat. That's how long the proc goes here. 2K, 1K, Baron going down.
Oh, this is going to be so close. It will be spiced away by Amazing. Vander's now trying to get out of here. And PoweroFEvil was going to follow after. He flashes over the wall, call him Roadrunner, because he's like, meet Weem, I'm out of here. Sven, oh, he's going to take him down. He's not getting out of anywhere. 2-0 to OG.
Yeah, I was about to ask the question, did Origen make the mistake from initially peeling away from that Baron to go for the fight? Because it seemed that they could do just exactly what they did just now. Finish it and then turn to win the fight. God, it doesn't matter. They claim multiple lives here as a Baron. Go for a siege.
So much damage onto Jankos. Sven is playing on the front foot. There was massive smiles from Pekko and Nico backstage. SoaZ may have bitten off more than he can chew there. Just an advance, fail flashes as well. Just donates a kill, a little bit of a facepalm in the player cams. But they got the talent, they've got the Baron, and it's remaining on four.
He just wants to rejoin his family, the trees there, as he toppled over, but it's fine.
To the forest.
Yeah. That was it. I didn't have anything else.
You interrupted me for that?
Yes, I did.
Separate Fate comes out of here. This is where I think SoaZ can defend the choke point, and Origen can just finish it, but it is a tricky call. Two of them turn right now. Look at Amazing Crawl the turn, and Mithy and Zven are kind of still in the barrier, so this indicates a tiny bit of communication error, but it's so hard to call that a big mistake. But then they use the Kindred ulti fantastically. They really understand the limits of the teamfights. They don't overchase. They have patience, vision denial, and then they started again here. Amazing. That cheeky Malproc, though, obviously you get lifesteal as long as you stay in combat, which is forever when you're hitting Baron. PoweroFEvil doing a fantastic job zoning here. Going to be a really nasty setup, though, here. But the Mithy shield right here, destroying all these projectiles from Forgiven that otherwise would bounce around in the pit. Imagine if that's two crits, that's instant wipeout. So the Braum shield really working in Origen's favor right there.
And that Braum was also first rotation pick on the side of Origen. Braum Kindred, seeing it in high popularity. PoweroFEvil is going to try and run away with the mini Sivir ult, but you can't outrun the real Sivir ult. Amazing is now the next target. He's in trouble. Lamb's Respite will buy time, and it's enough time for Mithy and Sven to arrive. They've traded back and forth. It's a mid laner for support. Odo's running interference, and he pieces out with the chrono break. Mithy's going to look for a tag on the Winter's Bite, but there's no one to follow it up.
Oh, SoaZ flanking.
Looking for the flank. Twisted Advance will be available, but it's going to need to be a tower dive. Origen have already got 4,000 gold from this Baron power play, and they want more!
Here's Maokai, and SoaZ will come out with a big damage from Q, and Sven will follow up with a godlike kill over to Jankos. 3-1, OG taking control over this game.
Again, H2K aggressively defending Vision and their jungle, making a pick. PoweroFEvil gets caught out. He spawns in 20 seconds with the teleport, but the chase from Origen and just the sheer amount of damage coming out once they do get Maokai connected with one of these targets, immediately obliterate here. Origen, they're actually looking much better than game one. Oh, even better, and they're looking to take this game.
Yeah, they're not done yet. Forgiven's forced to defensively use the ult. H2K have respawned, but Origen, they're not backing away yet. Unbreakable will come up to prevent Mithy going down. Unfortunately, not going to be enough. I think the Ignite may have finished him off. They've got a kill into Forgiven. It's 10 seconds before Ryu's back alive. Origen, they're looking at the Nexus turret.
Chrono break back to safety. Amazing, he's on the towers. He's on to Odoamne. He goes down. 3-0. Mithy sacrifices his life for this one, but Jankos, he's going to try and defend, but there's not much H2K can do here. Ryu comes in with a big damage onto Sven, but he dashes away, dips and dives through the fight. Jankos will be dropping as well. Make that the ace for OG, and they'll be finding the first win in this series.